If you're starting a new project that requires you to use a luciferase assay for the first time, you probably have some questions. Questions like, so what do I need to know in order to get started? What should I look out for? And how does a luciferase assay work? We're going to answer those questions and more right now. What is the luciferin-luciferase reaction, and how does it work? In nature, bioluminescence occurs when chemical energy is converted into light inside a living organism. The process occurs when luciferase catalyzes the oxidation of luciferin, resulting in the emission of light. This diagram shows the actual reaction process, where luciferin is catalyzed by luciferase in the presence of ATP, oxygen, and magnesium. The result yields oxyluciferin, carbon dioxide, AMP, and light. What is a luciferase reporter assay? A luciferase reporter assay is a test that investigates whether a protein can activate or repress the expression of a target gene using luciferase as a reporter protein. The synthesis of a reporter protein and the addition of a substrate results in a chemical reaction with a byproduct of bioluminescence. This bioluminescence directly corresponds with the effect of the protein on expression of the target gene. How do you choose between using a luciferase assay and qPCR when you're examining gene expression? Here's what to keep in mind. The qPCR method is going to measure your gene's transcripts. It's not going to tell you about the control of transcription. With luciferase, however, you can measure promoter activation and transcriptional regulation. Another thing to consider is how deep do you want to look at your gene regulation? You might find that performing both techniques are a must in order to understand major aspects of your project. Some important features of luciferase assays. Extremely sensitive. Reproducible/compatible with internal control reporters. And uses non-radioactive reagents. Some useful applications of luciferase reporter assays are gene expression analysis, promoter structure analysis, SNPs analysis, antiviral research and therapy, cytotoxicity assay, and drug discovery. What am I going to need for the luciferase assay? You're going to need your reagents. You can either use a kit which supplies you with everything you need, or make your own solutions. For the necessary reagents, refer to our in vitro luciferin handbook, link is in the description. As far as equipment, you need a luminometer. You may already have one, and if so, take note of whether it's a microplate reading luminometer or a single-tube luminometer. Find out if your instrument has injectors or not, and find out what wavelengths your instrument works on and at what temperatures. This is all going to help you further down in planning your experiment. The microplate luminometers allow you to read samples and well plates. This can range usually between 96 wells and 384 wells. The single tube luminometer, on the other hand, is going to read a single microcentrifuge tube. You'll also need tubes or well plates depending on what instrument you choose. The plates you need for this assay are flat bottom. They were especially designed for optical measurements and cell culture applications. Do not use round bottom well plates. Clear well plates allow you to see your lysates, but the drawback is that you can get background luminescence from neighboring wells. White well plates will prevent that background. However, you can't see the lysates while you're working with them. The white plates with clear bottoms will allow you to see your lysates and prevent background issues, but they are expensive. Just keep those factors in mind when deciding what route to take. How is luciferase activity measured? To measure luciferase activity of the cell lysates, you will need a multi-wall plate or a tube containing cell lysates and a luminometer. This apparatus detects the photon emission produced from the luciferase reaction, and the unit of measurement comes out as relative light units. Usually, for many luciferase assays, you won't need to select particular wavelengths. It's better to use a luminometer with an injector for particular types of luciferase assays. The injector dispenses a substrate into the cell lysate, and the reading of the well starts immediately to minimize the possibility of diminishing signal. What are the basic steps of the luciferase assay? The steps of the luciferase assay are going to remain very similar whether you're doing a dual reporter assay or a single reporter. Choose your luciferase reporter gene, for example, firefly luciferase or Ranilla's luciferase, If you're doing a dual reporter assay, make sure your luciferase have different spectral measurements. Clone your reporter into your plasmid. If you're doing a dual reporter assay, then you will clone your other reporter into a separate plasmid. Co-transfect your experimental cells with your plasmid. After an incubation period of 24 to 48 hours, remove your media and lyse your cells. Add the buffer containing luciferin to the lysate. The light from this reaction can be measured with the luminometer. These are the general steps you can expect to follow. Your method is going to vary to some degree based on the type of assay you're performing and the objectives of your experiment. Which luciferase assay method should I choose? There are several different types of luciferase assays to choose from. There are flash types and glowing assays. You could also perform a single assay or a dual assay, or even in rare cases, a triple assay. This is all going to depend on what you need for your experiment. Flash. The flash type luciferase assay, which is the most common assay type, means that upon adding your substrate, the reaction is going to happen very fast. You have a very limited amount of time to add the substrate and measure the light emission. When working with a single assay, this won't be much of a problem. Let's look at a hypothetical scenario where you would be working with a 96-well plate doing a flash assay. If you were using a multi-channel pipette, because the assay runs so fast, by the time you finish pipetting into the final wells, you'll have lost maximum sensitivity in your first wells. It could be impossible in that setup to get an accurate reading. Another option when running your experiment with a 96-well plate is to pipette substrate into a single well, get a reading, and then move on to your next well 96 times. This is possible to do, but it's going to take considerable concentration and patterning in your behavior to get the consistent results you need. As mentioned earlier in this video, some luminometers are designed with injectors that automate the process of adding substrate, making it immediate and consistent. This ultimately solves the problem you face when working with a lot of samples in a short period of time. But these luminometers require more substrate for an experiment, because some substrate is always lost. Also, using more substrate prevents the possibility of you running out in the middle of your experiment. Glow assays. Maybe you don't have a luminometer with injectors, but you've got a lot of samples to work with at a time and you want to ensure consistent results. The glowing luciferase assay is an alternative that buys you time. GoldBio's DuraLuck assay kit has a half-life of nearly 3 hours. This allows you to pipette substrate into several wells before the signal fades. This also lets you compare results over multiple plates. The glow assay can provide you with the accurate, consistent read your experiment needs. The downside, though, is that it's not as sensitive as the flash type. Single reporter assays versus dual reporter assays. Single reporter assay. You might lean towards a single reporter assay because it cuts costs and time when studying expression. In the single reporter system, you would be only using Firefly or Ranilla's luciferase as your substrate, and then measuring emission from that alone. The drawback to doing a single reporter assay is the lack of normalization. It's not going to produce as detailed results as using a dual reporter assay. The dual assay system is most commonly performed with Firefly and Ranilla's luciferase. The dual system improves your overall accuracy by normalizing your data. In this system, one reporter will look at the experimental promoter activity, while the other is going to be used as your control for transfection efficiency. The Firefly luciferase is going to measure experimental conditions, while the Ranilla luciferase is going to be connected with a constitutive promoter measuring the transfection and cell viability. The order can be reversed, and Firefly luciferase can be used as your control instead. It is important to choose reporters with spectral differences in order to get an accurate read. As always, if you found this video helpful, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more content. Below, I'll have a link to the products and protocols mentioned, as well as some other links about luciferase assay. Thank you for watching and for all your GoldBio support.